Tragically to this region?
Yeah.
like, I can't talk here and I can't talk back here. He was very clear about the amount of destruction here. So that's what I didn't know. Okay, I've got shot reference. Do you, and you don't understand that? And you have a female, but not a mom, but she's the mother figure?
Yeah, she was always the mother figure.
And it was pancreatic? And you're sitting very close to each other, so let's just see where this goes. And I'll just ask that you speak in the mic if when you answer. And so can I ask what the potential move would be? Because they just showed me a for sale sign or a real estate issue.
Our house is for sale.
Right now for you?
Yeah.
Okay, so because they just plopped down this real estate sign, which just means like currently or there's something in the way of working towards. Okay. You have your hair's covering you. Have you had a mole you need to have looked at or checked that's on your shoulder or neck region?
No.
And have you?
No.
I don't think I'm with you right now. I think there's something that he wants me to acknowledge about a female having something checked with their neck. Oh, you get that, but it's not you?
No, I get...
Hold that up to your mouth.
Yeah, I do. I had a skin tag on my mother-in-law remembered.
Your mother-in-law did?
Yeah, so she did.
You're jack of all frickin' trades. You had a skin tag off your neck removed by your mother-in-law.
I actually saw the scar.
Well, I can't see shit.
It's very light. It's been a couple years.
But I promise you, your friend or whoever he is to you is trying to acknowledge that or make reference to that. How bizarre. And the for sale sign.
Yeah.
And all that. So he needs you to know that he's still connected to you guys and in your life. And he had, now I don't know if this means in general personality-wise, he had a big mouth. And he says, I should have kept my mouth shut.
Yes.
And that has a lot to do with why he got shot, where he got shot. So I don't know why, but I feel like there's something verbal about his mouth and him not either letting something go or an antagonistic thing that he's talking about that seems, I don't know if it's personality or about the event, but he's laughing about having a big mouth and I should have kept my mouth shut is what he said. So, you understand? You can stand with her. Like, support her! You stand your ass up. And I don't mean to be rude. You put your arm around your mother-in-law, because you know what? A lot of people in here want to kill their mother-in-law.
Yeah.
And you brought her, or she brought you, to show your love. But you know this young man too? Okay. Because I don't know his connection, I just know he's young, and I know what he tries to bring across and show. And skin tag, hey? That's wild. And there's a joke about boobs, and I'm sorry, but he's bringing this up.
Yeah.
You don't have to tell it, and you don't have to even say who it's about, but I'm telling you, he's killing himself laughing over a boob joke or something about a boob for somebody.
My name's Jessica, but he used to always call me T.
Tits? So that was his nickname for you?
Yeah.
I wish they said tits, but that's vulgar. I was hearing boobs.
But you could always say T because he was trying to be respectful.
T! Thank God he didn't go so. Or he would have been P. That's funny though, the boob joke. So thank you. He's a little lively in the way that he's coming through. Why does he make me feel like he got himself into trouble? He got himself into trouble because I feel like that goes back to his mouth.
Yeah, he was loud and he brought trouble on himself.
Okay. I don't know if any of that leads up to how he dies or not, but he's kind of doing like a past thing and it's like big mouth and I didn't help myself out and I created problems and I just didn't know better at the time. But you need to know he's okay. The one thing I want to rule out, is this your son or something? Okay. You needed to have your ass up.
Yeah.
Yes, you did.
I don't know.
You're funny. And I'm sorry for your loss, and I mean that. But you need to know he's okay, and that he still is referring to you as, well, boobs today. And the skin tag, and all that great stuff that, you know, there's things he could tell you about you and your husband that were curling your toes? He's like, I'm not going there.
He was my husband.
Oh, he was your husband. Because he's like talking about the sex life thing. But it's like he doesn't want to bring it out and talk about the sex life, but he's like, I could curl your toes. Maybe he meant that more than one way, I don't know. I don't know, but he's like curling your toes about the sex talk that I'm not going to talk about. Perry was thinking you had a brother-in-law that called you D.
No.
So it's more fitting when it's a husband.
Yeah.
Okay. He thanks you, and not just because you're the wife, he thanks you because you did what you could or you tried to support in a way, and you gotta let it be enough. You gotta let it be enough. And the two of you, not just here today, but be your support system, because there's somebody that's not supporting you. There's somebody that doesn't give you the support that you need living in your life. I don't know if they're not capable of it. I don't know if they don't know how to do it. Or I don't know if you let them. Because you're probably a
tough girl.
Tough girl. Mic up when you talk just so they can hear you.
Tough girl.
Okay. It sounds it. So, there is something though where I feel like somebody that you should lean on or should feel that you can lean on doesn't know how to deal with you or what to give you or how to help themselves even. So there just seems to be a little trouble there. Do you understand? Or no? There's not a family member immediately to you that you feel like you can't talk to or you don't get support from in regards to the loss of your son? And were you really, I won't say the word, but effing pissed with police?
With police?
Yes.
Yes, we were.
Yes. Because he's like bringing up this, like he's saying the word,
yeah.
I won't here in my office, I don't hesitate. But talking about the police and the disrespect, the way that I feel, the anger, meaning you, and maybe you, but it's being directed towards mom at this point.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
Okay.
Yeah.
You need to know that whatever this is with the throat and this, and that physically took him, he's okay. He is okay. Is the third important or significant?
Well, it's only been 8 weeks.
Oh. Oh.
Yesterday.
8 weeks. What's the third represent, or why is he saying three?
He was born in the third month.
March?
Yeah.
Okay, because it's either going to be the third, like whatever month, or it's going to be the third of a month. Is the way that it works. If you ever hear John Edward, it's the same.
Yeah,
the
third month that he's passed. This is going on 3 months.
You do the math. I don't know. He's bringing up a thing about the third or the three or whatever this is that seems time related, whether it's the time that's passed or whether it's significant about the third month. But there's something he's trying to acknowledge about that. 8 weeks, hey?
Yeah.
You're not ready for this. Have you been thinking that maybe, but you haven't committed to it? Maybe?
No, I just don't want to cut it now.
You can't do that shit. You can't do that because he wanted it or because he didn't like it. People, take lessons. You cannot live your life for the dead in the way that they wanted to live because the equation has totally changed. Okay?
No, I'm not going to get here. But he did have a thing. Come on
here. And geez. So, is there a son? Because he wants me to acknowledge the son and talk about the little boy. So he's around him. And he loves him. And his death didn't change that. But he's sorry. He's trying to be funny because you're too sad. You know how people, guys, take a dog or a baby to the park and they're like chick magnets?
Yeah.
Thinking that little guy will get to somebody. Seriously? And that was the joke? But he's like, I don't want to say prostitute the kid out, but dress him up really cute and let's go. Let's see what mama can bring home. I promise you have a hard time hearing that, but I promise you, your son is a better version of who you remember at this very moment. And he was probably a damn good one in life, so don't misread what I said about that. But he's not plagued, and he's not affected by, and all this stuff, that he needs her life to go on, and he's going to use humor. Was he funny in life?
Yeah, way too funny.
Personally, as a medium, I love these types of people.
Annoying.
So now I can be his voice box today, and be the annoying one. It's like, I'm sorry, what's your first name?
Jessica.
Take your time. You don't have to have all the answers. You are in, like, okay. His analogies. You know what a meat grinder looks like when they make hamburgers?
Yeah.
The process that you're in going through the meat grinder of life, you're up to your ankle. Your foot's in the meat grinder. You've got all this to go through yet as far as the grief, the dealing with, coming to terms with. But what he talks about is in the way, you don't have to have all the answers for your son right away. And it's not something that has to be answered all the time. And I don't know how old he is, but make a kid appropriate. And as he gets older, you tell him more, or you tell him what you want him to know. But he puts no pressure on you. You will keep him alive. And he will always know who his dad is. But I think you will struggle this coming year or two, and maybe more, but in what to say, what not to say, how to say it. And he trusts you to do a great job, but don't feel like you gotta, like, do it. You can't. The kids are resilient. He will weather this far better than you. And that's just the way kids are. So he's like, don't tell them everything. I think you have like an open book policy.
Yeah, I do.
So he's like, no. Not this. Do it age appropriate, or I'm not telling you would say inappropriate stuff, but.
That makes sense.
Okay. Because, you know, people nowadays, they want to walk the kid through a book and this is your penis. And I'm not judging that. They should know the right names, but he just makes me feel like age appropriate. And he doesn't need to know everything right now. Do you just have the one child?
Two.
You have two. He's only showing the son. Is the son the oldest or the youngest?
Yes.
Okay. Where's the B connection coming into play?
His name is Ben.
The son?
Yeah.
Okay. Cause
no, his name is Ben.
Oh, his name is Ben, your husband, yeah. Her son.
Yeah.
Okay.
Brenda.
I'm sorry?
No, Brenda.
You're Brenda, and he was Ben. Okay, I don't know what the name was to represent, but he just drew the B. Like, so there's something B named that he wanted me to acknowledge for you too. You told me your name, I got
Jessica.
You need to have a drink after this.
Yeah, I probably do.
That's what he's saying. You gotta go out on a patio somewhere.
Okay.
Not cold.
Okay.
Because he would like to have one, is what he's saying. And when you have the pleasure of that, you get to experience that.
Okay.
Will you sacrifice yourself and have one?
I'm actually going to work too after. On a deck?
On a deck. Because you need to have one with or for him, but no, he'll be there, is the way that he said that. And you might have a trip or vacation coming up and you might be a little hesitant about, but I feel like it's good to go. So I don't know how you feel about it, but was there something you weren't sure about?
We're going on a trip, but I didn't know if I should keep going further. And I was thinking that we're going to Cobalt for a family reunion, and I thought, well, maybe I should. The invite was to go all the way to Timmins, and I thought, oh, we'll just play by ear and see how I feel.
Okay, just enjoy. But I didn't know what was in hesitation or what was in question that he brings up, but he'll be with you. So it would be like a great experience. Do you have a daughter as well?
Yeah.
Because he's just showing in female energy now that he wants to acknowledge being around. And He's a shit. He's like, good thing she got my looks. And he's funny, because he's kidding.
Yeah.
Who she look like?
Depends
you?
On me, yeah.
Okay. Because I know he's trying to be funny and saying, good thing she got my looks. He loves you more than he can say. He just does. And he needed to be, or wanted to be, or had to be the first one through. And so he took his shot. What's not about, I don't think it's a school thing. What would be significant about September?
We got married in September.
Okay. Because it didn't have an education thing to it. It just, he wants me to talk about September being significant, important. You will deal with this, okay? That was the message. You will find a way through this. And the more you dread it or the lead up to it, you will make life hell on yourself. And you won't be a patient mom and you won't have what you need. And he's like, it's a date. I'm still with you. Don't let it eat your guts. Okay? Do you smell him? I hope that's a good smell.
I have a shirt in the closet that I smell him.
So it's not the over. Because I didn't want to know if you smell me.
And I kept it cologne.
I just feel like something about you smelling and his presence or being around that he's.
No,
that's not in the closet. What's that in the closet?
I did it from the monitor.
You'd be surprised what comes out of here. You've been, as far as I'm concerned, everybody can take a page from this girl's book because she's been an open book and she has shared things that most people wouldn't. But it's made her reading and the experience that much more, I believe. I can't speak for you. But you had the gusto to get up and to speak. And I thank you for owning that, because it takes a lot of energy for him to come through, me, because I'm just a pain in the ass. I get things wrong. I muddle things up. I'm the go-between that he doesn't want. And he just wants to talk directly to you guys. So when you have these feelings, do you smoke? You gotta stop that shit. I mean it. He just, I was gonna say, like, he's around you, you talk directly to him, and he's like, lecture her on smoking. He did in life? He lectured her in life?
Well, he smoked too, but he wouldn't say she could quit smoking.
Oh, a hypocrite. And the tattoo by her wrist or on the arm?
She's getting a tattoo on her arm. We were just talking about it. She did.
Jessica drew it on me last week.
Isn't that asking for you? He's in your life. He knows you don't feel him. It's raw. You have, this is not about my ability. You have been given a gift today that people don't get after 8 years sometimes. And you got it within 8 weeks. And it's fresh and it's raw and you're not ready to hear it. But you will have footage of this to go back on when you're ready. To listen to it when you're ready. And know that your son is okay and he's funny and he's retained the personality and he's sorry. And the fact that there was some anger that you guys have, he's okay with that. He's dealt with that. And you need to deal with it now, he says. You need to deal with it. And don't go looking. Mom, what's your name? Oh, Brenda. You said Brenda.
Mom.
You're just right that way, aren't you? I'm mom. What the hell was I going to say to you now that he wanted me to tell you? I got sidetracked with the way of comment. I'll have to let it go unless he brings it back. It was profound. All my love. I think he's coming back.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you. I have would either be like a daughter or a young female coming through, and I'm on this side, and I don't know how far back I am, but I need to talk about somebody having the S name or the S connection that they want me to acknowledge, and it feels female-based when I say this. So what I don't know is if it's Sally or Sandy or why I'm hearing this, but it's got that S-A sound to it. It doesn't mean the person passed with that name, but it's very much like when Kelly came up. In all of the way here, I just knew I'd be starting there, whether it was significant or not. Do we, and hold on, do you know, is there a dominant connection that's possibly passed here? Because I am on the left side. I have a girl coming through. I have a young female coming through. And, but I don't, okay, just wait and see.
I have a Sarah a lot.
Okay. But I have a young girl coming through who is deceased that is saying an S.A. name. It doesn't mean it's her name. It just means she's trying to identify or lock me in somehow with this S.A. sound. I need to talk What? Well, I get below, so she comes in like a daughter or below. It's the way that they link. I'm not getting an age, but they come in. You're confusing the hell out of me, woman. We need a microphone here, and I don't want to ignore this woman, because it could be here, although I felt the whole thing back. So we'll just wait and see what more comes through. Is there a second mic? Oh, Courtney, is it? Thank you. So, can you just stand for a minute? You may be sitting quicker than anything. I don't know. What would be the issue that I want to talk about? What I don't know is if it's a personal choice or if it's a medication thing, but I want to talk about like a substance issue in the bloodstream, or is this you? Okay. But the thing that you didn't relate to with the S.A. name that she might be referencing?
You said Sally, but her name is Allie.
Oh. Allison, Allie. Not Sally. And do you understand why I get the medication, drug, or substance issue in the bloodstream?
Yeah.
Because that's what's coming through. Okay. So I could be off on the name. I'm going to let you sit. Thank you. Let's just see. You're all together here?
Yeah.
I don't know who you are, but you have a lot going on in your life that you don't even know about yet that is coming. In such a positive, profound way, young lady. Passing or loss of her physically in your life changed this, she says. I don't know what, honest to God, can we have another mic? Courtney, sorry. Well, you both can have it. Maybe I'm going to have you stand, even the four of you or whatever, whoever's in your group. You stand. You heard me. You're not deaf. All I know is, you can't read that from your sadness, that you've got a lot of stuff that's going to, she has you on a friggin' rocket, and things are going to go fast at one point, and you're going to do very well, and it sounds very generic, hey, and something lovely you want to hear, but I can't say it to the rest of them, I can only say it to you, that something is very, like, you're shot somehow in a fast way. Do you understand? She's saying yes to them.
Yes.
Some of it you're not even aware of yet. It's like the tip of the iceberg, or there's like more to come that it has to unfold that you can't even think about or didn't like her with somebody? Didn't like her with somebody? Didn't like her with somebody? Because
yes.
She keeps, you know you can't blame them, whether it's one or more. You want to, but you can't.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Absolutely.
Honest to God, it's like took everything you have not to choke the shit out of somebody.
Yeah.
I don't think you're a violent woman.
No.
But she literally showed me how you so could have easily at one point. I don't know if you would have fully succeeded, but I felt like wanted to choke somebody. Don't make it fit. She says absolutely. You don't know.
Or my husband.
I didn't.
Yes.
She's like, you didn't do it.
Nope.
What's the truck? The truck? The truck? Is that your husband? Why would she show me the half ton? I assure you, she's showing me a half ton. Who's got the white truck? I don't think it's brand new.
They're saying they know somebody has a truck.
Hold the mic up. Just, well, why would she make reference to a truck connection with somebody she knows? So she's talking about half ton. And it's either white or it's a light colored truck.
It could have been the last person that was like
that. That might be significant in her story or in her life of why she would talk about the truck. Is this not something we know?
No.
Because she's bringing up something about the person with the truck. To me, a male. A male, not a female. But she talks about a male, and she talks about like what to me would be like a half-ton truck, or it's not a car, in the way that she's showing this. I can't say this to you, but I have to. Have some kind of a thought that somebody left her to die or let her die?
Yes.
She's like, I'm so sorry that that's your reality or the nightmare that plays through your head. Are you mom and daughter? Hug your mom. I don't know what this means, and I don't know the accuracy of it, but I almost feel like it could be somebody that maybe knows she's in distress or not well, but didn't do something about it, or walked away, is the feeling.
Yeah.
I can't tell you there's motive or intent, because she doesn't bring that up, but she makes me feel like that's a bitter pill to swallow, thinking somebody didn't realize what was happening to her. And she says, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. She's not one about pointing fingers, though, for blame.
No.
She made decisions and choices.
Yes.
And she's really sorry about this. And did you not get to see her when you first needed to see her or wanted to see her? That's you? So is there something where you, like, wanted to go but they stopped you or wouldn't let you? What's funny about that?
I went to the hospital.
Right up.
I went to the hospital and they keep on putting them. They wanted to see her.
And they wouldn't let you?
They wouldn't let me.
Because she's sorry about that. I just knew it was a female, but I thought mom. So. She's kicking ass over there. I don't know what that means. Excelling, or I don't know what you excel at over there, but I feel like her personality is getting larger. And she's like, I'm kicking ass. Somebody at the pool and they hate the pool? Somebody hate having a swimming pool? Most people love the freaking swimming pool.
Water with
it. Well, so don't say me. What's that mean?
I just prefer water to be 90 degrees.
La-di-da. Do you have a pool?
No, I don't know.
You have the pool. But you don't go in it because it's not warm enough?
No, I'm a water wimp.
A water wimp. So you have the pool, but you don't like the pool. So whatever that means. And it's here in the family?
Yes.
Okay. Why do I think you like the beer by a fridge or something?
Because I have a bar in my house. Very much enjoy it.
Good for you. She makes me feel like if you moved a bar fridge by the pool, your mom is embarrassed. Your mom is horrified that you said you have a bar and you enjoy it.
No.
She's joking about, my sister and brother-in-law have a beautiful pool and pool house and a gazebo thing. And so I'm seeing that, and she makes me feel like maybe if you move a bar fridge out closer to the pool, not close enough to fall in and electrocute you, but maybe your ass would get in the pool if you could reach for the beer out of the bar fridge by the pool. So she seems to be funny and laughing with you. And this is not a pool thing. Are you all sisters?
Awesome.
True, yeah. You'd love for me, she'd love for me to say, "Your sister." Which, there's a chicken shit aspect for one of you, and what I want to say is there a tattoo thing? Where somebody might be in the chicken shit.
Me.
She's, listen to the red hair, she's got your number today.
I got a tattoo about 7 years ago, a really, really big one on my side, and I thought I was real brave. And I got the outline of one letter, and I had to leave.
So do you have like one letter to follow, or you got removed?
No, I finished.
Oh, you finished. I can't talk about all of you, but she talked about one of you being a chicken shit over a tattoo. That's cool. That's a good one.
And that's exactly what she would have said too.
Chicken shit? She had things on the horizon she was so looking forward to, was not taken quite seriously enough yet, but was optimistic and was looking forward to doing this. And you know, I can't pretend to say I don't know what the biggest regret or issue is in grief, but she makes me feel like you need to know I don't miss out on this stuff. I am truly connected, and I'm still advancing with what I need to do, because I feel like that's what she's kicking ass about. So even though it seems like, I can only assume for the most people, they focus on what she'll never get to do, what she'll never get to see, she'll never be aware. She only lived X number of years, and she died so young, and she will never get to the next 6 decades, or whatever it is. And that's what keeps you trapped in the grief. That's what keeps you trapped, because if you're gonna look back, then you gotta do it with thanks. And say, how old would she have been, 20?
23.
23? Okay, so then look back and just say, or focus on, like Donna said, I choose happy today. And she says, if you're gonna look back on those 23 years or 22 or whatever it is, then you gotta look back with thanks. You know, she wasn't always easy, but you gotta give thanks. That's what she's saying. I wasn't always easy. Look, kids, I got 4. They're not easy. They're no picnic. I got one here today that's no picnic. She cost me a fortune too. But she's a good kid. She's a good kid. She wasn't easy, but she doesn't miss out on things. She wants you guys to know that. Have we? What the hell is this? Have we just passed a birthday, or are we just coming up to a birthday? We just passed a birthday? She brought that in so friggin' quick.
My daughter turns 6 on Sunday.
Happy birthday. Honestly, she was there, because I honestly, the way she brought it in, it was so timely, I didn't know if we just passed or if it's like just happening. Why are you tough on men? That's the second time she said that. Or let mom talk, or your sisters, because they'll throw you under the bus quicker than... And mom will.
Guess I'm a little hard.
Are you married?
No.
No, but
yes, but no. Listen, I've got a granddaughter. I wanted a wedding. It didn't happen. But they're happy together. I still hold hope that one day there'll be a wedding. But it is what it is. But she does. Twice, she's brought it up before, and I didn't say it because you were bawling, and your mom was giving shit over saying you like booze. But then she said it again, and it's like, you are hard on him, so watch. And I'm not saying you're going to push him away or any of that, but it's just what she sees, something that I couldn't tell you why, and you might have every right. I have no clue, but she's cautioning you, and she's done it twice. But I had to say it funny, like, you're hard on me. So, she just wants you to know, okay? And does somebody have a cartoon decal? Would it be for your daughter that's on a wall? that, do you reference that as being her aunt or something? Or is there something about a wall? Something on a wall that you say, that's Aunt Allie? Or, because there's something that she's showing me that I feel like I need to connect to a child, but in a room, and it's like, there's Aunt Allie, or that's Aunt Allie, or something of that kind of connection.
She was a bit of an artist, and she drew this beautiful painting of Marilyn Monroe. The upstairs, her other personal effects.
In your house?
Yeah.
And do you ever say or acknowledge, like, that Allie did that, or that's Aunt Allie, or something to that effect? I don't know. I'm not putting words in your mouth. But there's something that's image, or, like, that's why I said it's her cartoon thing. Not that it looks cartoonish, but I didn't feel like a portrait or a picture.
It's just so, it's so beautiful. Everybody
comments on it?
Comments on it, so I always let them know.
Her heart just swelled. Honestly, no, and it's not an ego thing. Her heart just swelled that it means that much to you. That it means that much to you.
It's so beautiful. She's an amazing artist.
That's nice. That's nice. Sorry, I called it a cartoon. Be a little clearer. What's your dynamics? Would you try to wear her shoes? And would that piss her off?
No, she would wear mine.
Your shoes? Yeah. Would that piss you off? Well, I got stories about my two little chickadees. And my one daughter comes home from North Bay for the weekend. Her sister, who they do love each other, but and she leaves for the weekend to go to the boyfriend's, you know, because we're nothing. And she calls back, oh, I forgot. You didn't know this, Shelby. Oh, I forgot. Can you grab that new shampoo and the expensive cream rinse that I left in the shower and hide it? Because that bitch will use it all weekend. So is it that kind of thing?
Yes.
Okay. Because there's just something shoe-based to you that she was directing. And she's having a lot of fun doing this. Having a lot of fun doing this. Is there something why... this is not fair to do in a public format. You know, it's kind of iffy if I'm saying that. Is there something where one of you are closer to Dad than the rest? Or have an easier time and, I don't know, something about Dad is different for one of you in a more positive or better way or easier way?
Allie and I had different fathers than the other ones.
Ah, okay. So...
And she was closer to him.
To her dad than you are to your dad?
She was closer to our dad. So
oh, you and Allie share the same father.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I thought you meant Allie and these two had the same father. Okay, so is there something about... And she was closer to him than you are? Or were?
I guess I feel that way, yeah.
I can't put words in your mouth, or I should. So, but she's bringing something up about, one, being closer to Dad than... I thought all of you, but... That's the feeling.
Dad helped her out a lot more, I think.
Oh, sibling rivalry. Wow. You know what she just said? Apparently not. Or it'd still be there. That's what she just said.
She has a point.
So you're barking up the wrong tree, she says. And one more thing, 13th, the 13th, why 13 or the 13th? Okay, hold on. Why would she pull me to September? Why would she want me to talk about September? And why do I want to say like around the 13th or the 13th or something?
Yeah, I'm
going to
start school in September, the
8th. On the 8th? I'm seeing 13, but I feel pulled to September for some reason. And what's a big butterfly doing?
Dragonfly.
Is there a big picture of this, or does somebody have like a big image of this? She just made it big and it's colorful. Remember what I'm saying. There's something that looks like butterfly, not dragonfly, but I could be wrong. Big and colorful, and it looks like a picture. And there could be something on top of it, or in front of it, or something was added to it. Is the feeling she's giving me. but it feels like it's in, on a wall and it's up on a frame or something of that nature.
I'm not sure.
I don't know the time frame. Did you have successful surgery down below? Down below, female stuff? I'm not
I have a bladder split.
I don't think guys get that. I could be wrong, but I don't think we do.
No, I don't.
No, we have prostate issues.
That was the last time I really hung out with
her. Around this time frame? And it was successful, though. Whatever this is. Okay. I'm mixing you and your mom up a lot, even the pool thing. So. I'm going to ask you, because she's not saying it, how long has this been?
11 months.
So it's not even a year. Do you have the damnedest time on how to talk to people, or is there something awkward for you about how to talk or when to talk about something? I'm not talking your family. I need to talk outside your family. So when it comes to Allie or how you're feeling or something, is there a reason why she would make me feel you're very guarded?
No.
Do you live in Barrie?
Close to.
Why would I see something with the, like an apartment building or something? There's something about an apartment building like that I'm seeing from outside. So, if you're speaking, just speak into the mic close.
She passed away in a, not an apartment building, but it was a taller building. Upstairs.
All I know is I feel like I'm outside looking. Is there multiple living units in this place, or?
I'm not sure. I don't think so.
Do you have any ties to, like...
My dad lived in a condo on the water. He lived up high, and she lived with him for a little while. He loved it.
Oh. You don't talk to that dad?
No.
Because she makes me feel like you have a difficult time about talking about something that was outside your family, so I get he's ex-family, but she brings up something about difficult, and then I'm seeing like a high-rise or an apartment building, and it's like I'm looking from the outside at it. So he used to live in that, she used to live with him, you don't talk to him? Huh, connect the dots. I don't know if that's it or not. And there's really something funny about your driving. I don't know if that's today or what this is that she's laughing about that you three should not nag her about.
Yeah.
You think
is it her music?
No, there's something about driving. Somebody sucks or somebody didn't pay attention.
Maybe.
Really?
Yeah.
Who drove here?
My mom.
Was there something said to you about the way you drove? She's laughing. What did you, oh, microphone, what did you say? Because I feel like it's about something coming here and she's laughing about this. Right up to your mouth. Say it. Come on.
She tried to...
Hold it up.
She tried to leave, like, drive into the driveway and my door was still open, so I...
Gave her shit.
Yeah.
Because what I can tell you is, it wasn't about you as much as I could pick on a young person that doesn't know how to drive. It was you. And there was something funny, and I felt like it's about... I might have been pulled further back. I'm sorry?
Two males?
I think there could be two males, but I feel like I've got a dad or a father figure coming through. I think there's a second male energy, but somebody did something very abrupt with me where their death came very quickly, and there was some kind of internal bleeding or a bleed out or an artery thing. So can you stand? I don't know. You keep listening, okay? I'm not ignoring you. The only thing is I felt pulled back. Do you understand some of that? Or are you making it fit? Or you don't know?
No.
You understand? And you understand why there might possibly be two coming through? What would be the bleed out or the quick bleed out thing internally?
Gunshot.
Another one? The only reason I'm not saying no to that is because of the speed and the abruptness of which death would have happened, and this like severing of something where I feel like this bleed out. So I don't, obviously the person dies because of the gunshot, but there's something where I feel like a bleed out, and but some main artery or something was cut so quick by this that they didn't live like long at all. So
that could be right.
You don't know.
I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
It was here. So.
Right there.
Yeah.
Okay. That just indicates too what that is. Yeah. Just so you know.
Sorry.
He didn't say suicide, but that indicates that.
Yeah.
So he can't say that now, and maybe he wouldn't have. I don't know. The person yesterday didn't say suicide either. Just kept saying sorry. Who's Bill, or why do I want to say Bill? Because they're saying acknowledge Bill.
Yep.
Who's Bill?
He's my grandfather.
So he's dead?
Yep.
He might have had a stroke, or he might have had an aneurysm, or there could have been something. Yep. No?
It's a different person.
Okay, I don't know why, but I feel like I need to acknowledge Bill. So he might be the father figure. I don't know if I'm doing the levels wrong or what, but just know they want me to say Bill.
Yep.
Okay? And you're not here with a mother or mother-in-law, are you?
No.
No. So there's something that I need to say to you because I didn't want to say it, but I would have. But I didn't want to say it if she was here because I put my foot in my mouth many times. You need. Yeah, okay.
That's my husband.
That's your husband. Hi, husband. Are you henpecked? You're one of five men here today.
He loves this stuff.
On the dicks, I guess. And Max, my little Frenchman son-in-law, is seven. So there's seven of us. What was I going to say to you both?
Something about a mother-in-law.
You need to learn to speak up, and that's not what you thought I was going to say. That's not what you thought I was going to say at all. And see, and there's issues where I want to say you need to say what you need to say and then be done with saying it. But be very clear, because you haven't been, or he doesn't allow it. Whose mother? His or yours?
Both.
Could really?
Both.
Seriously? They're that bad?
Both? Yeah.
You got no reprieve. Usually you got one you can go home to. I feel like you need to speak up and you need to just say it once and that's it, and not debate, not
explain.
And there could even be a little ass backwards, backhanded approach that they do, like, or one of them, where they're like, oh, is that what you meant? Oh, I'd already done it this way or something. You got to be very clear. That's his mom, isn't it?
It's both.
Really?
Yep.
She just said, are you related? But I think she means you were brother and sister before you're. Or the mother's related. That would make not sense either. what am I supposed to say here? This was not, how do I, not the same method, but it wasn't the first time or first attempt. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
You speculate or you know?
I speculate.
He makes me feel like it wasn't the same way, but I seriously contemplated and acted out in one way, but it didn't work, and he was might have been scared to follow through with it.
Yeah.
So.
I can see that.
He do you, is this like a son to you?
No.
What's the connection?
He's like my stepfather.
A stepfather, so the father's thing right from the start. Where does the young male come into play that's deceased then, that they want me to acknowledge? Again, in a trauma. Where's Mike? People around you, listen. Where would the Mike connection be? And why would I get a trauma or a male killed like in an accident or like forced trauma, impact? Okay, just wait. Is there people back there too?
Yeah.
So I want you both to listen. Because honestly, it sounds crazy, but I feel like we're running short of time and I don't know if more people are trying to hop in. Can you stand up at the back? Do you understand why I would get a male passed young, why I get the impact or trauma, and why the Mike connection would come up around this? Is it the Mike deceased? Was it like a vehicle accident or something very quick? Why do I feel like chest and head, chest and head? Seriously? We just need a mic. If we can, you just one, you keep one. Just right up close to your mouth.
My friend Mike died of head-on collision.
Okay, so just... Hey, why does he refer to himself as badass?
He always said.
A badass. He says I was a badass. I didn't think it was just necessarily about his driving. I think either his personality or his attitude or he was a legend in his own mind type thing, but he's like, I was a badass. If it's him, we gotta wait and see. Is he vulgar or funny?
Yeah.
I know he's a good friend to you.
Right.
I gotta say it. Flick your ears, ladies, if you don't wanna hear it. He's calling you pussy, and he's laughing.
He called everybody that.
Pussy?
Yeah.
He's calling you pussy. Would you ever consider a tattoo? You haven't done it though, right?
No.
So you're not going to do this either. Just trust me when I say this. He wants none of this small shit on your shoulder or back or God knows where else you'd put it. He wants something going up your neck because he thinks he's worth it. You're not going to do it. Is this your mom?
Yeah.
Or mom, he won't do it. Don't panic. He won't do it, even though he's of age. He won't do it. This guy who calls you pussy thinks it's really funny that you think of a tattoo, and he says, yeah, but if you're going to do it good.
Yeah.
And go up the neck and show how much you love me. You know, that type of thing. I'd say, nice knowing you.
Yeah.
This would be my response if I was you. He was a little much of the time.
Yeah.
Is what he just said. Like, people tolerated him, but there was times when he's around, it's not fun.
He's just ADD child.
There's some females that weren't particularly fond of him either.
His ex-girlfriend very much. Yeah.
Well, that's easy to say an ex-girlfriend, but it's actually like if there's a group of friends, there's some girls, two of them, that would prefer when he wasn't around. So maybe that's other guys' girlfriends. I don't know, but. I think he was a little much, is the way he says this. I don't think this is about him. What's the golf connection?
I was out golfing today.
Before you got here?
Yeah.
Wow. Because he just wanted me to talk about golf, but it didn't feel tied to him or connected to him in any way.
All like his friends who we all hung out with, we all golf.
It's like not really in honor of him, but you're all friends. And
yeah.
Did you talk about him today? Seriously? Out on the golf course? That's pretty freaking profound.
Golf tournament in his honor.
Today? It was a golf tournament.
We
talked about doing it.
Yeah.
That and the tattoo he just said. He just keeps showing that. And he's like, both. Because he's worth it. I get that's a big dent to have out of your life. Somebody that's that charismatic, I don't know if that's the right word, big, large, annoying at times, loud, you know when he's in the room or when he's pulling up.
Yeah.
But I get the absence of that, but the son of a gun has not changed in any way. He's overtaken your stepfather or whatever. I'll try. The profound thing for me was the golf. That was that time. Did you golf all the time?
With them, yeah.
No, but like in your life now, do you golf?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Well, then it could have been hit or miss. But to me, he's bringing up the golf reference. And did you not originally want to drag your sorry ass here? And then you changed your mind?
Yeah.
That don't offend me. He would have been pissed. Because he's taken his shot. Is there a leukemia connection tied to you guys in the family? A blood disorder or blood issue? So can you just speak into the mic and stand again? I don't know what this means. What would be either leukemia or a blood disorder or blood issue?
Was it leukemia?
Hold it.
Hepatitis, autoimmune.
Hepatitis, I understand, autoimmune, the autoimmune system. Did it affect the blood? Did it somehow have like a blood thing?
Yes.
She don't get it. She's not understanding it. She thinks you're an idiot for saying that. You're a hell of a nice guy. That's what... I don't know if it's Bill or the guy with the gun or what, but you're a hell of a nice guy. What's the blood thing? If it's hepatitis, who's that?
My father.
Is he living or dead?
Dead.
Because it would make sense if your stepfather tried to come through briefly, and then if your dad's trying to come through with a blood thing that would pull me back here when Mike was so strong but then fade back, that they just wanted me to end, like, about the blood thing. Of why they're pulling. Do you have a daughter?
Yes.
I don't know how many kids you have, but I'm telling you, you've got one where the freaking sun rises and sets on. That's all I can tell you. So I don't know what that means, and if you've got 3 or 5 or 10, or if you're like that family that have 19, God help you. But he's talking about one where the sun rises and sets on, and I don't know why. Who's got the A name? Because he wants me to talk about the A name. That does not mean the other ones aren't special and they don't have their little special plays, but I can't go through the alphabet. And he brings up the A connection for your daughter, that to him the sun rises and sets on. And I'm sure he feels that way about all of them, but it's your dad, I guess, saying this, you know, that's acknowledging this. This isn't funny, but you heard me laugh. Is your mom bitter? Is your mom bitter?
Pretty much.
No, seriously, yeah. Like not just as a daughter. Let's ask the son-in-law. You speak
bitter? What? Just bitter in general?
Well, I think, yeah, like can she be sarcastic or can she look at the negative? Can she?
She can definitely.
Yes.
Because there's this like, my glass half full or half empty?
It's half empty.
It's freaking empty. Just the way that he makes me feel. So. Oh, and you might have, I don't know if it's kidney stones, gallstones, something going on. What's to look for?
Me? Yeah.
I think you.
Me?
Think you, ponytail.
Oh, yeah.
So, watch for that, okay? Because I literally feel like I'm seeing a blockage or, like, that could be gallstones. Yeah, I don't feel kidney. Well, I don't know. I'm not in the body, but I feel here, and I feel like some kind of sludge or stone or something. So if you start having some kind of attacks or you notice digestively anything going on, have you?
My stomach's been bothering me a little bit lately, but I'm tired.
Like more than typical or not usual?
More than typical.
You might want to get a check.
Okay.
Because he's making me feel like, I'm sorry, Linda, I took off on you.
That's okay.
I think there's something forming or going on there. So if you've had recent digestive things that are out of the blue, you might want to head start on that, just
okay.
to see if anything's, because apparently that pain is pretty bad.
Yes.
Yeah. Which mom comes to you guys?
Which mom comes to you?
Yeah, we'll stay, or we'll stay for a short period of time. We're dreading somebody coming.
No.
Somebody's coming. Somebody's coming, and we're not looking forward to this little picnic.
Okay, well, would be my stepmother, maybe?
Yeah, they're all the same
to
me.
Yeah.
I don't mean personality-wise, but a mom's a mom. See, you've got a mom, a mother-in-law, and a stepmom.
I do.
Wow. somebody's coming for a short visit or a little stay or something, that's like, I'd rather put a nail through my eye.
Well, you know, my oldest son's birthday's coming and we're having a family dinner.
Get drunk. Seriously. A couple of my guys before they get there. You don't have a balcony, hey, like on the Muppets, and you stick the old people up there and let them get bitter together. There's something where I just like honestly have a little drink, and you're not looking for a word to this, but you will get through it, is the way that they're saying it.
I always do.
And husband, dad, how many kids do you have?
Three.
Three? Not all little girls or all little girls?
One girl.
One girl. Oh, so, okay.
Yeah.
So then why the sun would rise and set on a little eight?
Yeah.
Okay. Screw the boys. they're tough. They can handle them. What does dad do that's either a little red wagon or assembling something that they would show me that I feel like is kid-based, which might sound very general? I'm telling you, there's something you just put together or pulled.
You just put together?
Well, I think so. I want to give dad credit.
Oh yeah, I wouldn't have put it together in a Mario Kart. A Mario Kart, it's like a Power Wheels kind of thing.
What is that? A Mario?
Mario Kart, it's like a Power Wheels that he drives.
Oh, yeah. Has dad just done this?
Yes.
When?
A couple of weeks ago.
Okay, because just know that these dads are watching, and they're talking about what you put together or assembled for the kids.
Yeah.
Okay? So, they're watching when you do things for the boys, not just little Annika. Okay? Thank you all for coming out today. It's after 4, I know. Shit. Oh, damn. Remember? Oh, damn. Oh, damn. Now, listen, we got to do the 50-50 draw. And as we head out of here, whether you go out quickly or not, I got books to